Hello, I'm Teddy Bercovitz, Principal PM in the Power BI team. With me, my coworker.
Hey everyone, I'm Srihari Srinivasa. I'm a Principal Product Manager in the Power Apps team in Microsoft.
We worked hard this past year on making these products, Power Apps and Power BI, work much better together, and we're super excited to show you what we've built. On the agenda, we have, first, we'll show you how these components actually work and how this integration works for you. Then Srihari will show you how to actually embed these components inside model-driven apps. We'll close with showing you the near future investment we're planning to do and kick off a feedback in a Q&A session. So what's the problem today? Until today, it wasn't possible to include Power BI artifacts in a solution, which resulted in application breaking on deployment between tenants or environments. And not only that, if you, for example, wanted to embed a Power BI report inside a form or even pass context to that form, it would require XML editing and even breaking and creating unmanaged components in order to achieve that. There are three major capabilities that we delivered with this integration. First, adding a Power BI report in a dataset is now native, and you can add it easily just like any other Power App component. Now, we also learned that Power Apps admin need to import and manage many solutions in an environment. So making it super simple to import a solution with Power BI component without extra steps will now work. Importing a solution package will automatically provision all the Power BI artifacts you need in order to use them. And we haven't stopped there. In order to create the close integration that we can actually achieve in order to maximize the strength of this Power App platform, we even abide to the layering system that Power Apps has. So when you import a managed solution, any unmanaged changes that you make can actually be exported as unmanaged changes, or you can even remove them in order to go back to the managed state of the solution. So let's go ahead and explain how it actually works behind the scenes before we show off the demo. First off, you begin your work by having a Power BI report and a dataset uploaded to Power BI service in a shared workspace or any other workspace that you have write permission for. Once you've uploaded the Power BI report dataset to the service, you can now add and create Power BI components. Once you select add existing Power BI report or a dataset, you will be prompted to select either from Dataverse or from Power BI. If you already created Power BI components, they will show up as from Dataverse. The important thing to understand is that when you add Power BI report and dataset to Dataverse, it actually exports into Dataverse, into that specific environment, and then it becomes part of that component as a payload. Now, when the component is created, it also creates a dedicated Power BI workspace where all the report and all the components will then be stored. Now, this dedicated Power BI workspace is in sync with the Power Apps environment and abides to solution operation. So if you delete the component from the Dataverse environment, it will automatically delete the corresponding report or dataset from the Power BI workspace. There is always a one-to-one mapping between the Power BI workspace and the Power App environment. Now, in order to deploy the solution across environment, all you have to do is actually just export the solution package. When you export the solution package, the solution zip includes all the Power BI report and dataset as part of the solution zip. So when you import the solution zip as part of a different environment, or even if you export it and import to another tenant, they will always work. And the only additional step required after importing a solution or importing a component is actually just to authenticate and share the dataset or report with other users. Let's demo how we're actually creating Power BI components and dataset in a Dataverse environment. So first up, let's get to meet the Sales Hub. This is a well-known Dynamics app that allows you to manage your sales lead and opportunities. In this demo, what we're going to do, we're actually going to enhance this Sales Hub Dynamics app and infuse it with analytics. So let's see how we do it. First off, we go to Add Existing and choose Power BI Report. Now notice that when I choose Power BI Report, I can choose either to import from Dataverse or from Power BI. When I choose from Dataverse, only components that were already created will be listed here. When I choose from Power BI, I'm listed with all the artifacts that I have permission in order to add to Power Apps environment. You'll be able to select a Power BI workspace. Selecting a Power BI workspace will list all the relevant artifacts in that workspace. And in this demo, we're going to select several Power BI reports. And please know that when you import a Power BI report, we automatically detect the dependency between the report and the dataset connected to it. And we will import the dataset as well in order to conserve some operation on your behalf. Now, importing takes a few minutes because the report and dataset are actually getting exported into Dataverse. And then they create components and dataset. Notice that the dependencies between the report and the dataset are also available in Dataverse. And looking at the dependencies between them will reflect the actual dependencies in Power BI. Now, we learned from our users that you need complete control on how to connect dataset to data sources without leaving Power Apps. For this, we created for every Power BI dataset that includes data source parameters, you'll be able to edit parameters right from Power Apps by selecting Edit Parameters. When you edit parameters, you will be listed with all the parameters that the dataset actually includes. So when you'll add a parameter, you'll be able to select it and choose from three different options. The first one is custom text, environment variables, or current environment domain. Selecting custom text will allow you to simply input a different text than the one in the parameter currently. Selecting environment variable will give you complete control on how to connect these data sources to different places. So for example, if you need to change sources between dev to prod and test, it's super simple by using environment variable, you'll get complete flexibility. Also, if you use a data source that is not Dataverse, this is the best place in order to achieve it. You simply connect the parameter into the environment variable, and any change in the environment variable will automatically be reflected to Power BI. In this example, I'm going to select current environment domain, which will give me flexibility and will automatically detect the environment domain I'm in currently, and will set that on Power BI. Now, notice that as I save the parameter configuration, the value is also set to Power BI and configured there. Now, let's head out to Power BI and see what we have there. When I open in Power BI, I'm navigated to the Power BI workspace. You can see that in the Power BI workspace, there are several things that allow me to detect that this workspace is actually connected to an environment, to a Dataverse environment. First off, you'll see the banner. The banner tells you that it's actually managed by Dataverse. You'll also notice the icon on the top left and the name of the workspace. We also always start with solutions, and then in it, you'll see the appended environment name. Wonderful. From Power BI, what you usually need to do is authenticate data sources, a schedule refresh, and other operations that you will want to control, such as sensitivity labels and others. Let's continue. Now that I'm ready, what I'll need to do is export the solution. I'll simply export the solution I'm interested. I'll export it as managed in this example, give it a version name, and export it. When I export the solution, I get the solution package. The solution package now includes the Power BI report and dataset, And anyone that will actually get this solution package will be able to use their dynamic sales hub analytics with our analytics brand. Let's continue. Now I'm going to import this solution to my prod environment. I simply import the solution. You'll notice that because in one of the datasets, I connected it to environment variables, I'm now prompted before import to set the value of the environment variables. As I set the value of the environment variable, the value will also propagate all the way to Power BI and set the right value, just like the environment variable in Power Apps. I import the solution. Notice that when I import the solution, a dedicated workspace is created if it wasn't until now, and all the report and the dataset components are there. Now, in this example, what we're going to do, we're not only just showing the app and what it can do, we're also going to use the full capabilities because these are actually standard Power BI report and dataset component. It means that you can use the full capabilities of Power BI. In this example, I'm going to even share in Teams this application and see what we can do right from Teams. I'm going to install it in Teams. Once I do it, let's see how I open the form. I open the form. Srihari will soon explain how this form is actually passing the filter. For now, let's just see what kind of capabilities I have here. First off, I can export to PowerPoint or to PDF or even analyze in Excel. And not only that, I can even get insights right in my Teams app and understand if there's any signals that I need to address. So let's recap. We have a Dataverse environment, which is connected to a dedicated Power BI workspace. If I connected the environment variable, it connects to a dataset parameter, which is synced to the dataset parameters in Power BI. Now, we even allowed you, if you want to use only Dataverse as a data source, you will be able to control and configure the dataset settings to automatically override the connection string with the Dataverse domain. So this is actually a very simple shortcut if you don't know how to create Dataverse parameters in the dataset. Let's continue. Last thing that we've done in order to make sure that you can actually perform this solution operation is that we're also syncing privileges between the Power Apps environment and the Power BI dedicated workspace. We've created 5 predefined roles which automatically sync permission with that Power App workspace. It means that if you're a system administrator, customizer, Power BI workspace admin, contributor or viewer, you will automatically get permission in the dedicated workspace, and you will be able to add new components, edit existing components, just like anyone, which will conserve a lot of time in you going to Power BI and sharing the workspace as well. This happens automatically in the backend for you. With this, let me move the microphone to Srihari, which will share how to embed in Power Apps.
Awesome. Thank you, Teddy. I'm super excited to be here to talk about some of the embedding options in Power Apps to take all of the solution-aware Power BI components and put them in business apps. Before we jump into the demo, I want to talk a little bit about how this is part of a larger term roadmap for us to bring analytics and business apps together by ensuring Power BI and Power Apps work seamlessly well together. So over the past few months, we've made Power BI quick reports generally available in model-driven apps, which means that all of you can take advantage of the Power BI capabilities with just a single click of a button and generate Power BI reports based on your views. Today, I'm going to talk a little bit about how we can embed the Power BI solution-aware components in business apps, specifically on dashboards and forms. So we're going to focus on those two scenarios. And we're going to keep improving this to ensure that we have support for lots of different types of scenarios. There are 3 main benefits for you to embed Power BI solution-aware components in business apps today. So firstly, this is part of a set of holistic support for Power BI solution-aware components to be easily embeddable in business apps. So your users can actually look at the analytics as well as business data in one single place. Secondly, all of the capabilities are actually built on the Power Apps component framework, which allows you a lot of extensibility options when you are embedding Power BI components in Power Apps. And lastly, we're also going to take a look at how the form designer support greatly enhances the process of embedding Power BI components in a model-driven form, which means that you don't have to edit an XML file. You don't have to know how to copy and paste different parts of a URL into an XML file. This is a complete low-code solution for all of you, so you can actually embed Power BI components on a form with just a few click of buttons. So let's jump into the first of the two demos. One of the main scenarios that we see is customers embedding Power BI reports on a dashboard. This is a really, really simple process for you. Teddy just talked about how to create a solution and import a Power BI report into that solution. So we're going to take one such solution where there's a Power BI report is already present, and we're going to take a look at how easy it is to create a dashboard with that Power BI report embedded inside of it. Creating a dashboard is really easy. All you have to do is create a new dashboard, and with this new improvement, you're going to see an option to see only the reports that are part of the environment. This allows you to access those Power BI reports that are solution aware, so you can easily select them. And creating a dashboard is very easy. With just a few clicks, you actually have a model-driven dashboard. And the next process is really simple. You go to the model-driven app that you want to add the dashboard to and create a dashboard and find the model-driven dashboard with the Power BI solution aware component embedded in it, and you insert it into the app. The next scenario that we're going to look at is embedding a Power BI solution aware component on a form. This, as I said, is based on the Power Apps component framework, and we're going to take a look at how easy it is to embed a Power BI solution aware report on a model-driven form. In the form designer, you're going to see an option to add a Power BI report component. This is the new option that's going to be available, and quickly drag and drop that component on the form canvas anywhere you'd like, and that opens up a list of things that you can configure. This is the power of PCF control, where you can actually look at all of the different configuration options that are available for you. You can hide and show things like the bookmarks bar or the action bar and have a default state for the filter pane, and also put in any contextual filters that you want to apply to the Power BI report when it's viewed on a form. So you can tap into the form context and ensure that the Power BI report is showing the right information for all of your users in your organization. And it's so easy to do. And there is absolutely no XML editing. Anybody can do this with just a few clicks of a button. Next, let's take a look at the roadmap. In the near term, we plan to announce general availability of this capability. We plan to also include the support for environment lifecycle operations so that your environment and the Power BI workspace remain in sync. We're also planning to include the quick create process of a Power BI component. So when you are in the context of a solution, you can actually create a Power BI report, include it in the solution, create a dashboard or a form, and you have the whole process done from the Solution Explorer. And we're also exploring ways to embed this Power BI component on a custom page. So you can take the Power BI report, which is now solution aware, and put it on any page and make it either a full page control or part of a page where you have other things in it. So we're really looking forward to delivering that for you. So head over to Power Platform Admin Center to actually enable the Power BI system solution to enable this integration. If you want to use the Power BI solution that was used in the demo focused on the sales scenario, you can get the package at this link right here, so you can experience analytics in your Sales Hub app. On behalf of Teddy and myself, thank you for joining us for this webinar.